An Elementary Course in Synthetic Projective Geometry by Derek Norman Lamer. Chapter 5, Pencils of Rays of the Second Order. Section 79, Pencil of Rays of the Second Order Defined. Section 80, Tangents to a Circle. Section 81, Tangents to a Conic. Section 82, Generating Point Rows Lines of the System. Section 83, Determination of the Pencil. Section 84, Brionchon's Theorem. Section 85, Permutation of Lines in Brionchon's Theorem. Section 86, Construction of the Pencil by Brionchon's Theorem. Section 79, Pencils of Rays of the Second Order Defined. If the corresponding points of two projective point rows be joined by straight lines, a system of lines is obtained which is called a pencil of rays of the second order. This name arises from the fact, easily shown, section 57, that at most two lines of the system may pass through any arbitrary point in the plane. For if through any point there should pass three lines of the system, then this point might be taken as the center of two projective pencils, one projecting one point row and the other projecting the other. Since, now, these pencils have three rays of one coincident with the three corresponding rays of the other, the two are identical and the two point rows are in perspective position, which was not supposed. Section 80. Tangents to a Circle. To get a clear notion of this system of lines, we may first show that the tangents to a circle form a system of this kind. For take any two tangents, u and u prime, to a circle, and let A and B be the points of contact. Figure 19. Let now T be any third tangent with point of contact at C, and meeting u and u prime in P and P prime respectively. Join A, B, P, P prime, and C to O, the center of the circle. Tangents from any point to a circle are equal, and therefore the triangles PAO and POC are equal, as also are the triangles P prime OB and P prime OC. Therefore, the angle POP prime is constant, being equal to half the constant angle AOC plus COB. This being true, if we take any four harmonic points, P1, P2, P3, P4, on the line U, they will project to O in four harmonic lines, and the tangents to the circles from these four points meet U prime in four harmonic points, P1 prime, P2 prime, P3 prime, P4 prime, because the lines from these points to O enclose the same angles as the lines from the points P1, P2, P3, P4 on U. The point row on U is therefore projective to the point row on U prime. Thus, the tangents to a circle are seen to join corresponding points on two projective point rows, and so, according to the definition, form a pencil of rays of the second order. Section 81, Tangents to a Conic. If now this figure be projected to a point outside the plane of the circle, and any section of the resulting cone be made by a plane, we can easily see that the system of rays tangent to any conic section is a pencil of rays of the second order. The converse is also true, as we shall see later, and a pencil of rays of the second order is also a set of lines tangent to a conic section. Section 82. The point rows U and U prime are, themselves, lines of the system, for to the common point of the two point rows, considered as a point of U, must correspond some point of U prime, and the line joining these two corresponding points is clearly U prime itself. Similarly, for the line U. Section 83. Determination of the pencil. We now show that it is possible to assign arbitrarily three lines A, B, and C of the system besides the lines U and U prime, but if these three lines are chosen, the system is completely determined. This statement is equivalent to the following. Given three pairs of corresponding points in two projective point rows, it is possible to find a point in one which corresponds to any point of the other. We proceed then to the solution of the fundamental problem. given three pairs of points, AA prime, BB prime, and CC prime, of two projective point rows, U and U prime, to find the point D prime of U prime, which corresponds to any given point D of U. On the line A, joining A and A prime, take two points, S and S prime, as centers of pencils perspective to U and U prime, respectively. Figure 20. The figure will be much simplified if we take S on BB prime and S prime on CC prime. SA and S prime A prime are corresponding rays of S and S prime, and the two pencils are therefore in perspective position. It is not difficult to see that the axis of perspectivity M is the line joining B prime and C. Given any point D on U, to find the corresponding point D prime on U prime, we proceed as follows. Join D to S and note where the joining line meets M. Join this point to S prime. This last line meets U prime in the desired point D prime. We have now in this figure six lines of the system, A, B, C, D, U, and U prime. Fix now the position of U, U prime, B, C, and D, and take four lines of the system, A1, A2, A3, A4, which meet B in four harmonic points. These points project to D, giving four harmonic points on M. These again project to D prime, giving four harmonic points on C. It is thus clear that the rays A1, A2, A3, A4 cut out two projective point rows on any two lines of the system. Thus, U and U prime are not special rays, and any two rays of the system will serve as the point rows to generate the system of lines. Section 84. Brionchon's Theorem. From the figure also appears a fundamental theorem due to Brionchon. If 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are any six rays of a pencil of the second order, then the lines L equal to 1, 2, 4, 5, M equal to 2, 3, 5, 6, N equal to 3, 4, 6, 1 all pass through a point. Section 85. To make the notion fit the figure, figure 21, make A equal 1, B equal 2, U prime equal 3, D equal 4, U equal 5, C equal 6. Or, interchanging two of the lines, A equal 1, C equal 2, U equal 3, D equal 4, U prime equal 5, and B equal 6. Thus, by different namings of the lines, it appears that not more than 60 different Brionchon points are possible. If we call 1, 2, and 4, 5 opposite vertices of a circumscribed hexagon, then Brionchon's theorem may be stated as follows. The three lines joining the three pairs of opposite vertices of a hexagon circumscribed about a conic meet in a point. Section 86. Construction of the pencil by Brionchon's theorem. Brionchon's theorem furnishes a ready method of determining a sixth line of the pencil of rays of the second order when five are given. Thus, select a point in the line 1, and suppose that line 6 is to pass through it. Then, L equal to 1, 2, 4, 5, N equal 3, 4, 6, 1, and the line M equal 2, 3, 5, 6 must pass through L, N. Then 23, LN meets 5 in a point of the required sixth line. An elementary course in synthetic projective geometry. This book was written by Derek Norman Lamer, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, University of California. It was published by Ginn and Company, Boston, 1917, and is now in the public domain. The text is available for free download at Project Gutenberg. Read by Jim Renholt. Programming and Illustrations by Jim Renholt, 2020. Corrections and comments are appreciated. Thank you for listening.